and his brethren, and gave him possession in the land of Egypt, in the best of the land, in the land of Ramesses, as Pharaoh had commanded. And Joseph nourished his father and his brethren and all his father's household with bread according to their family. Not only are they living in the best of the land, but they're getting the best possible care that they could get in the land. They didn't start off in a bad situation. Egypt for them was a good situation. It was the place to be. Out of all the places in the entire land of Canaan, there was only one place that had bread and nourishment for their family, and that was in Egypt. Egypt was a place of salvation for the children of Israel, but over time, something had to change. If everything started off fine, then the question becomes, how did they go from being a people of prominence to a people of persecution?
All right.
What happened in Egypt that caused them to be afflicted in the place where they used to be appraised? Did they change? Or did the circumstances change?
Yes.
And that's what you need to focus on in dealing with your Egypt experience. If your Egypt experience didn't start off difficult, then what happened that is difficult right now? Somebody changed. Either you changed or the circumstances changed. In Israel's case, it was both. Israel changed because they started growing. Did y'all catch that?
Mm-hmm.
Israel changed because they started growing. And how many of us in here know that there are some people that can't handle our growing?
Right.
Amen up in here. One of the reasons why you have a difficult Egypt experience is when you start to grow spiritually, there are some things that you're not going to do that you used to do. There are some places that you're not going to go that you used to go. There are some folk you're not going to hang around that you used to hang around. And sometimes Egypt becomes a difficult place because you have messed around and learned better. And because you learn better, you're starting to do better. And there are some folk that don't want you to do any better than what you're doing right now.
Amen.
Long as y'all struggling together, everybody just fine.
Yeah.
Long as you don't know nothing and they don't know nothing, everything is good.
Yeah.
But the moment God starts to bless you to increase, you start to have some problems. The only problem or change that Israel made or had was the fact that God was blessing them to grow. The circumstances changed because Pharaoh, who exalted Joseph, messed around and died. And a new Pharaoh come on in the room. Many of us are dealing with difficulty because not all Pharaohs are bad Pharaohs. The first Pharaoh was a good Pharaoh. That Pharaoh recommended that they get the best position in the land. You might be dealing with something on your job that the boss you had look out for you. The boss you got can't stand you. Come on in the room here. I'm trying to make it practical for you. You might be dealing with a situation in your family that you had one family member that made sure you were all right and that everything was well with you. But when they passed away, the rest of them sought the opportunity to tear down what they tried to build up. You're in your Egypt experience. Not all Pharaohs are the same. The good Pharaoh has passed away. Another Pharaoh has arisen. And this fella is a paranoid fella. ain't nothing worse than dealing with a paranoid Pharaoh. Because he's going to think that you up to something.
Yeah.
come on in the room here. Notice that this Pharaoh, the Bible indicates Exodus chapter 1, and beginning at verse number 6, the old one died. Children of Israel began to multiply. Land was filled with them. New king rose up, didn't know Joseph, and said to his people, verse 9, behold, the children of Israel are more and mightier than we. He is looking. That's what Pharaoh doing. And you're like, he's looking. He watching. He's watching God bless you. He's looking at how God is increasing you. He's looking at God's favor being made evident in your life. And rather him just join into the blessing. He gonna try to find a way to stop the blessing. He tells his folk. You know, Pharaoh always got some folk. Don't be surprised when you find out who Pharaoh's folk are. Because he's always talking to his folk. And his folk are on his side, even though you don't know that they're on his side. Come on in the room here. Come on, let us deal wisely with them. Lest they multiply. And it come to pass when there falleth out any war, they join also unto our enemies and fight against us and get up out of the land. Now, none of the children of Israel, biblically, have even inferred a conversation talking about getting out of the land. Hello in here? I mean, after all, they are in the best in the land of Egypt. They're being well fed in the land of Egypt. Everything is taken care of. They are contently dwelling where they are. God is blessing them to prosper. They are becoming numerous. And the land is being filled with them. Pharaoh decides that maybe they are faking. You follow what I'm saying? Now this is what he's thinking. And in your Egypt experience, the Lord don't ever want you to get caught up in what Pharaoh's thinking. You're going to mess around and miss your blessings. Worried about what Pharaoh is thinking. Pharaoh going to think what Pharaoh want to think. So don't you become overly concerned about what Pharaoh is thinking. You just keep growing and letting God bless you because you're growing. Pharaoh is thinking that maybe they are planning that if an enemy comes against us, they don't side with the enemy. Fight against us and get up out of the land. They didn't need an enemy to do that. Pharaoh has already indicated that they are more and mightier than we are. They could get out anytime they're ready to get out. You follow what I'm saying? One of the blessings of meekness, Bible indicates as a fruit of the Spirit, is the ability to have your strength under control. That means I could have more power than you and not have to exercise my power over you. When you really know who you are, and when you really know whose you are, you ain't got to get into no contentious battle with Pharaoh. Pharaoh is intimidated already by you. And you don't have to do anything to further the intimidation. He's thinking that they are planning to get out of there. So in order to maintain control, Pharaoh afflicts them with birds. Pharaoh's tactic is if I can just keep them burdened down with difficulty, they'll be so focused on the difficulty that they won't think about being delivered. You won't recognize if I make trouble for you that you're stronger than me and mightier than me and more than me because you're so focused.